This album was a convenient accident. I was not planning on recording a full album. When's the last time I listened to a full album? And I pulled out High Voltage. I actually listened to High Voltage twice, and then Highway to Hell, and then Back in Black. Kind of reminded myself of the spirit of rock and roll and why, you know, we do what we do. I picked up my guitar and I set a little Marshall stack at the end of the couch and a little mini stack, and I was playing these riffs, and then I realized I was just inspired. Just like perfect timing. I mean, while I'm sitting there doing that, I had several, like four ideas that I just, one right after the other, was pouring out of me. And my son walks in the door.
I'd been out on the road touring, and I always take the pit stop through Kennesaw, Georgia to catch a free dinner. When I was in the house that evening, my dad was ripping through some riffs on the guitar. And
I said, go lace up the drums. And I called Roman.
If you work with Jesse, you're always on call. He calls, hey man, I need you to come over and put some bass down.
So in true fashion for my dad, we get in the studio and it's like, okay, what are we doing? And he stands there and he thinks for a minute and he just starts playing stuff.
Nigel's standing there with his sticks and Roman's got his bass around his neck and they're both looking at me like, okay, now what? So we end up with a body of work, an entire album's worth of material. And I didn't really have a lot of lyrics. I had some lyrics in certain places. And I thought, man, I don't know if I could ever get away with it.
He tells me he got a phone call from Uncle Brian. Brian Johnson, singer from AC/DC.
After we'd tracked this stuff, again, just like it was meant to be, the phone rings. Hey, Jesse, how you doing, me son? You know, and I'm going, hey, Brian. He says, I'm drinking some of your whiskey.
And so the thought of the two of them actually collaborating on it was pretty cool.
Before we hung up, I said, look, I wasn't going to call you, but since you called me, you know, I've got these songs and you got to help me write them. And he goes, send them down here, me son, because I got a whole notebook full of stuff.
Well, I don't know, but I'll be a Joe. It never gets so singing rock and roll.
In the demo process, one of the tunes in particular, Brian's voice was on there. So there I am tracking a song with Brian Johnson's voice.
Nigel, being my son, I had the opportunity to shape him. When he was growing up, we'd listen to the 60s stations and the early 70s stations. You know, those great drummers and guitarists and singers that just found that pocket, that backbeat. And it's just natural for him. And the way he finesses the hi-hat, I don't even know if he played a ride cymbal on this entire record.
As Nigel was definitely, you know, far beyond his years as a young little dude, but he learned pretty quickly about how things were and how things are. So it's been really cool to see him grow up and become not just the guy that he's become, but the musician.
When I got custody of Nigel, he was just, you know, 6-7 years old. And we all pretty much raised Nigel. He always slept in the bunk right above me on the tour bus.
I was the top bunk, driver's side, front, right above my dad. I was known for having the candy stash. And I didn't realize this at the time, because I was a kid, when everybody would sneak off and partake in their recreational marijuanas and whatnot.
We'd be reaching into the foot of his bunk and stealing all his candy.
And they ate my candy! Or I don't have any Pop-Tarts left! That's just part of molding that child into the man that he is today. Roman is such an old soul. I mean, matter of fact, him and Nigel both are really old souls. Roman plays with his fingers. I mean, you just can't get any more soulful on a bass guitar than when you play with your fingers. I don't even think Roman would really even have to tune his bass to do what he does. I mean, because he could just put the notes where they need to go.
Never really know what it's going to be. I don't even know if he knows what it's going to be at the time. And everything sounds amazing.
Roman's been part of all of the things that I've done, including they're my solo records because I'm a mouthpiece and singing, but make no mistake about it. I mean, this record is Roman Glick, Nigel T. Dupree, and myself being the lucky bastard that I am, and being able to sing and play and just enjoy those guys and enjoy the music that we make together.
I just want to come over and just, you know, play bass for Jesse, man, because that's what I said I would do almost a quarter of a century ago.
This album has just got a core element that a lot of guys just can't touch.
I think when people get a hold of this record, they're going to have the same feeling that I did. They're going to be saying, where has this record been?
It takes a certain understanding, and definitely it takes a certain vocalist with a certain personality type to deliver it.
Just come over and we do it and just make the magic there.
We were able to capture that, and it was pretty cool.
This album is called Breathing Fire, and it is just a slab of rock and roll. From the first song to the last song, it's just a groove and a celebration of the fundamentals of rock and roll in its purest form. Just something I'm very proud of all the way around, from the sounds to the playing, playing with my son, playing with Roman, and every song, from the beginning to the end. It's a great album.